I mean, you did pin you did you 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 did pin Vlad once. I didn't do much.
Welcome in, everybody. It's the coach. This is Madden 20 on EA Sports. On tap is what should be a pretty good matchup between the Washington Redskins and the Atlanta Falcons. I'll be back with you again with scores around the league at halftime. But kickoff right around the corner. And standing by to call the action, here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
On a gorgeous southern afternoon, EA Sports coverage of the NFL takes us to Atlanta, Georgia, and inside Mercedes-Benz Stadium. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Washington Redskins and the Atlanta Falcons.
What did he get fired?
Hello again, everyone. Brandon Gordon along with Charles Davis. And Charles, we take a look at this Falcons team as they interplay. It's been all systems go in this first month. They're off to a 4-0 start.
And his scout folks believe that this is a team that's built to go all the way. You can't win the Super Bowl in September, but they're telling everyone that they're going to be there in the end.
Meanwhile, for the visiting Redskins, we're in October now, so everybody should be coming into form, shouldn't they?
They really should. And what you have now is a full routine established about what you want to get done and full focus on the season.
The first quarter of the season already in the rearview mirror, and off we go in week 5 on EA Sports. This will be taken in at the 1. He's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. So out comes the Redskins offense now onto the field. They'll be led out by the third overall pick in the 2008 draft, the man they call Matty Ice, quarterback Matt Ryan.
And they said he would be a gym rat coming out of Boston College, and nothing has changed, and his play continues to get better as he rallies his team.
Carry for Darius Geis, and give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
On second down at 4, Ryan. This one complete to Jordan Reed, and he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down.
They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the ball. I don't know what happened last week to really hurt their performance and hold down their production, but I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
And that was a good start, getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets on them, and that's how they motivate them. Most of these guys are self-motivated. They have a lot of pride in their performance.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. From midfield now, here's Ryan. He'll get this to his speedster, Paul Richardson. And that's going to be good for another first down as the tackle's made at the Falcons' 39. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10.
Come on, baby. Let's see what you got.
On the ground with Bryce Love, the former Stanford Cardinal. A gain of 3, 2nd down. The starters defensively now for the Falcons. In that win last week over the Giants, they were very good.
Yeah, they just held them to a field goal. So to them, that was an almost complete performance. Because, you know, when you really shut someone out, that's complete. But that's pretty darn good, isn't it?
3 yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7. Now a toss. This is Geis. And he tried to bounce it outside, but they'll stop him behind the line. It's a loss of 2. Now 3rd down. So add that tackle for a loss to the two that he had a week ago.
And you know what he's doing right now?
Smiling?
Yeah, definitely doing that. But he's also patting his guys on the back, his defensive front, because they're keeping him clean, meaning no one's getting to him as a blocker. He's able to run through the football. And the plays he's making, he's spilling them in the offensive backfield.
And that's going to be good for another first down as the tackle's made at the Falcons 28. Now Ryan on first down. Got a man, that's Quinn. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. That'll wind up going for a loss of four. And that's going to make it second and 14.
Well, I know it goes against the instincts of the person catching the ball, because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage, even though they completed the pass.
As good as a sack.
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
On third down, Ryan. Jordan Reed has it. And he'll be brought down with the first down and a late flag here, too. And he may get a few more tacked on for good measure. So give him the yardage on the pass and half the distance to the goal line.
Because they're inside the 30, so now you don't march off the full 15, right? Yeah, half the distance to the goal. In any event, that's precious real estate given up.
And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Washington. Matt Ryan, his sixth touchdown of the season, as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. A long opening drive, but a very successful opening drive. We call that methodical, I guess, when it takes that many plays.
Methodical and almost like a boxing match where you're hitting them with body blows. They can withstand them here. Look, they gave up the touchdown, but you don't feel like a knockout is there. But they keep doing that in the fourth quarter, that's when the knockout occurs.
And becomes tough for that defense if they're on the field that long. We'll see if they can continue that in future drives. So here the Falcons now as they get set for their opening possession. They'll be led out by their quarterback, a product of NC State. It's Jacoby Brissett.
Depends on what it is, because I don't know if I want to reveal too much about it. Hey, come on. Minus 54.
Wild Bill. A first carry now for Kareem Hunt. This will go for five up to the 33. A glance at the starting unit, Julio Jones, a threat on the outside, of course.
Combines great athleticism, incredible speed, and a whole lot of toughness to be one of the better receivers in the NFL.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five.
Ain't no such thing as a loss. We take wins home.
They'll run for the first time with Johnson. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. 6 yards to pick up, and that's a first down.
If my wife would be too happy about it.
Let's make these babies cry.
Oh, yeah. I mean, any situation. Let's make these babies
cry. We're set on first down. Got his man. That's the Pro Bowler, Julio Jones. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30.
It was better.
33 yards
at
that time.
At the time, it was better.
That was an excellent read right there. Saw cover one. That means it's just a single high safety. So you know if you throw the ball to the outside part of the field, help is going to be a little bit late getting there. And he puts one out there for a big-time completion.
Up from his linebacker spot, Deion Jones making the play. But a look now at our starting defense. They come into this one down at the 27th position in the league, Charles, against the run.
One thing you do know, you know they'll be fired up because they're facing a top five rushing attack. And even if they have early success against them, they got to remember they got to sustain it, because teams that are top five, they don't stop running the ball if they don't get things done early.
Yeah, Superman, you're already living there.
56. Mike, 56. Right there. 56.
On second and nine, Brissett. And that going to be incomplete. A lot of contact, no call, and it's third down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
Brissett. And he fires Throws one, but incomplete. Great coverage there all around. Really didn't have many options to throw the football.
Very little chance that that one was going to be completed. Every receiver was locked up.
And this one is right through. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So, yes, it's only three, but at least they're able to answer back after giving up the touchdown to start the game.
Yeah, I like the observation there because getting some points on the board, very positive for them. Feel a little bit better about things because if you don't score, you potentially have opened the door for them to score again, and then you're down 14.
Let's go, fuck. So does this mean no release for us?
Out there ready for this next drive, the Redskins offense. They had the touchdown on the opening drive of the ball game. It was countered by just a field goal. So, hey, if your guys can do that for four quarters, you're in good shape.
Yeah, it is a team game, so that's just good complimentary football. But, you know, I know I'm no brainiac, but you trade sixes for threes, things are going to work out in your favor.
Let's go. Kill, kill, kill.
On second down, Love. And he will lose yardage on the play. Back at his own 19-yard line. Officially, it will go as a one-yard loss, and that's going to lead to a third down. So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now third and long. From the gun, it's Ryan. It's brought in by Dodson. After one, 7-3 to score on EA Sports.
Let me finish this game and then I'll start the download.
Ryan, that's going to be caught by Richardson. And they'll get to him after a gain of 7 to the 47. Well, seven yards to pick up on the pitch and catch.
It'll probably just be
as this game continues to evolve in the NFL, you know how much coaches love run after catch, but you know what they love even more? Completion.
Yeah, just holding on to the ball.
Catch it, cover it, tuck it away. Whatever you get after that is almost gravy. That's how a lot of these receivers are being taught now.
And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40.
Now, that was pretty. They executed that curl route versus zone coverage, and that changes things a little bit because against man, it's often a tight curl, a tight, sharply run route. Against zone, you're just looking for that open spot, that dead area, so you may curl a little bit wider just to get to that place.
And usually a tight window. He fired a bullet in there for the completion. With a carry on second down. And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. That's going to go down as a loss of 5, and it brings up third down. The Redskins on third down. A perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. This is third down and 12. Ryan. He's got his man. This is Jackson. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down.
You don't even know which kid you're
talking. One hallmark of good defenses. It's understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. These kickers now, it's like we take them for granted. Kicks like that used to be such a big deal, and now you just expect them to make it.
Yeah, you're exactly right, and we shouldn't take them for granted. But I have a theory about it. You want to hear it?
Yep.
They are more athletic now than ever before. Talk about kickers. Trace their backgrounds, trace their histories. You'll find that they were big-time athletes all along, but their kicking was so prevalent that we made them specialists.
Well, and now those 50-plus yarders seem easy for some reason.
Here we go. Wait, Daniel has a kid?
To begin the drive, here's a handoff to Hunt. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down. The free safety roaming all the way up to the line of scrimmage to make that stop.
How about Daniel's his ability to trust his eyes and figure out it was not a pass play and go fast towards the line of scrimmage in order to make that tackle?
Now this one over the middle into the hands of his tight end complete.
it is hard in zone coverage to stop a curl route because when they see it, they just try and find the open spot and sit down.
Yeah, we always talk about finding the soft spot in the zone. What's the key to doing that? How do you do it?
You have to read what the coverage is. Is it too deep? Is it three deep? Because then you know where the linebackers are going to drop, what spots on the field they naturally get to, and you find that open space, and then you're in sync with your quarterback.
Hey, there he is.
He should be reading the exact same thing, and they put the ball right on you.
They stay on the ground. This time it's Johnson. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage.
Well, we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete. Austin Hooper, the tight end, was the intended target. But now it'll be third down. They come up to the line now facing a third and 10 after the incompletion. Out of the gun, Brissett. Complete to Jones. The completion good for only six, and that'll bring up fourth. They'll break the huddle here and go for it. This is fourth down. Here's Brissett. Going right side here, and that's complete. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
That's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
And the win last week punted four times as this one's away. Oh, and what a play on special teams here. This is going to be down inside the five, all the way down at the two-yard line.
And he's got to be fired up about that effort. I don't think he could have walked down and placed it any better than where he ended up putting the football. That's excellent.
They start on the ground with Geis. And he was very fortunate there to get out of his end zone. He maybe got back to the two-yard line. The safety, Keanu Neal, there to make the tackle. Second quarter action with 1:59 remaining. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in. And I don't know if he made
safety.
It out of the end zone. No signal.
Nice.
Yes, it's a safety. And you know, the man who sat in my chair the last few years, he has a theory. These plays, these safeties, they're so rare. Maybe they should be worth more than two, maybe 4 points.
I think he's got a great point. I really do, Brandon. But I would go ahead and up it to six. I'm a former defender. To me, that's like scoring a touchdown.
Easy now. I'll go four. I don't know about six.
Come on, come on. Come up to six.
A lot of points. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
So one play and they're already just shy of midfield. From the gun, here's Brissett. Oh, a battle for it here, and this will be caught. A nice pickup there, 18 yards, first down Falcons. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. From the shotgun, it's Brissett. And finding the tight end, Hooper. 12 yards is the pickup. Good for a first down for the Falcons.
I have one of those.
I talked about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide it. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete. From the 21, it's second and 10. Brissett again.
Oh,
incomplete, but a penalty flag is down in the backfield.
Holding.
Let's get the call. That hold coming from the left side of the line.
Hands got caught in the cookie jar on that one, and the flag came out. Penalty against them.
And in the air once more, it's Brissett. Under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 38. Montez Sweat. The blitz works to perfection as he gets in there to dump him for a loss of 8. Brissett from the gun on third. And they've got the hookup. This is Olsen. The Redskins now going to use the first of their 3 timeouts as they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. He made his first attempt, this from 45, and his kick is good. And that will cut the lead down to just 2. So the 3 points here, they're still down, but they put somewhat of a dent into that lead going into the break.
Anything helps when you're trying to chip away at a lead, but they do know that they're going to need a little bit better effort in the second half.
Well, it's a combination of Jacoby Brissett can't make
that's fielded in the end zone. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. Out there ready for this next drive, the Redskins offense. You've got less than 30 seconds left here in the half. You're well on your own side of the field. What are we doing here, Coach Davis?
Well, I'm trying something on first down. And it's something that's safe. It's something that's been done many times before. A lot of people say it's not even working. But I'm running a draw, I'm running a screen. I'm seeing if something pops. And if it does, that can alter my strategy and potentially get me some points. And if it doesn't work, well, then you just run the clock down and go to the locker room.
Now a run with Geis. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. The Redskins going to go ahead and use their final timeout as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. Geis showing he's going to be an important part of this Redskin backfield as he's in there again for first down. Out of the gun, it's Ryan. Looking long for his tight end read. And that'll be incomplete with just 6 seconds left on the clock. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. To throw again. Ryan, he's going to loft it deep right sideline into a double team, and it's intercepted. It's Desmond Trufant. So we have reached halftime here in a tight 2-point contest. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thank you very much. More from you, too, in just a bit. But first, let's get everybody caught up with what's going on around the NFL here in Week 5. We'll start over at Raymond James Stadium in Tampa. And they have just about gone to halftime with the Panthers out on top. Mark Ingram has a touchdown there.
Okay.
From there, we'll keep the Florida theme going as we head north to check on the Jags at home in Jacksonville. And they were winners in their ball game over the visiting Buffalo Bills. 23-13, the final score.
So he can name offenses because of his bum foot.
Finally, let's get down to Miami to see what's going on with the Dolphins. In that game, all tied with the visiting Patriots. Meanwhile, in our game, it's been a defensive struggle. Which offense can break through in the second half? To find out, let's hand it over to our broadcast team of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. And they start the second half with Johnson. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
But no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
On second down now, it's Hunt. And this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of 2, 3rd and 1.
Tough first half for him, unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing. But with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
This is Hunt.
Of the halftime, Mings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that blocks
him. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. The sack by T.J. Watt, or as his mother Connie calls him, Trent Jordan Watt.
Okay, was it a breakdown in protection? Did the running back not pick him up? What does it really matter? Sometimes it's just a great play made by the defense. Big time sack.
Looking to throw. Pace. And this is going to wind up incomplete. The coverage there too strong on the deep ball, and now they face a third down.
We've seen these defenses make enough opportunistic plays to keep this one low scoring. Flying around, making plays on the ball, and we see yet another errant throw as a result.
Throwing on third and long. Pace. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
Well, we're into the second half now, and this is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off. On the return comes Cobb.
Illegal block in the back. Return team.
So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. Here's Geis. And he'll take this up only to about his 18-yard line. Foyasade Aluakon made the tackle there from his safety position. Second and seven. Ryan, that's complete to Cobb. And he's taken down. It's a gain of three from the 17 to the 20. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down. From the gun on third down, Ryan. And that is incomplete. They don't get the hookup there, but you really have to marvel at how precise he's been throwing the football these last couple weeks.
Oh, that's the perfect word for it, precise, because if you're at 70% or better 2 weeks in a row, you have a job as long as you want one in this league, won't you? I mean, let's face it, it's not just West Coast offense either. He's putting the ball downfield as well.
That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And the Falcons will be taking over first and 10. Here are the Falcons as their offense heads back onto the field. These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They've got to just take a deep breath, relax, try and figure out what is working, and call more of that.
Looking to throw on second down. Pace. And incomplete. Fair to say, hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better. Got to get more help. Obviously, one that should have been caught. They got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. A nice pickup of 23 on the third down conversion.
The new
50 play.
On first down, they'll run with Hunt. And they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down.
I think it's pretty evident. We can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments. Looking downfield for Jones. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down.
Ready?
From the gun, Pace. He's got Sanu. And he's going to get this inside the 30.
Nice catch right there. Brings to mind the sentence, when in doubt, find your veterans.
I used to laugh back in the day when they would call guys like him crafty veterans. You get up in your 30s, you're still playing receiver, but you're around that long at that position, you're doing something right.
Just remember this. When he was young, he thought the crafty veteran was simply a guy who couldn't run anymore. Now he understands a little bit better.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. Here's a second and seven. He completes it to Jones. And down inside the 15 he goes. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. This quarterback now perfect since the second half started. 7 of 7. It's first and 10. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and 9.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right. He's pretty much been completely neutralized. To throw on second down. Pace. And that is caught.
Touchdown.
Touchdown, Falcons. Taywan Taylor, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Falcons have taken the lead. His first career touchdown pass, and yeah, it's cliche to say, but he's probably been envisioning this since he was a little kid. That's a cool moment.
It really is. So enjoy the moment, enjoy the time, celebrate, save the full reflection for later, but make sure you grab someone on the sidelines and say, hey, make sure I get that football, okay?
That's fielded in the end zone, and no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. A look at Washington as they come onto the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7. Past the 30 to the 32.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, 2nd and 3. Here's Ryan. It's hauled in by Doxson. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. The Redskins have the first down on a pickup of 18.
They sure put the coverage guys in a stress on that one. They thought they were going deep. Ends up curling inside for a nice chunk of yardage.
Ryan now 11 of 15 through the air. Here's 1st and 10. From midfield now, here's Ryan. Out to the left, it's complete to Doxson. 12 yards is the pickup, and it's good for a Washington first down. So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. Back now here on EA Sports. It's the Redskins with the football, but trailing here as we get down to the good stuff. Quarter number 4. On 1st down, Ryan. Looking for his tight end, Reed, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 22. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Falcon defense has a touchdown.
And remember, this is the number one defense in the National Football League. There's a good example of why.
Shows that they set an aggressive tone, not just stopping the run, not just getting after the quarterback, but the ball's in the air. They treat it like they're the receivers, and they went after that one and took it all the way.
Point after, right down the middle, and it gives his guys a 12-point advantage. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. This will be taken in at the one. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. And here come the Redskins now. And following the pick six, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early.
Don't you need levels
to let him get settled back in?
But they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
Second and 10, it's Ryan again. Caught by Cobb. And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. Second down pass play got him 8 yards. Now they've got a third and a couple remaining. Complete. Richardson has it. And he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here and a late flag as well. I think this one's going to be a face mask. Well, when you're leading in the fourth quarter, that's not the penalty you want.
Not at all. And now your discipline comes into question. Having poise this stage of the game, you can't have those kind of plays.
On the draw, this is Love. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here. On second and inches, Ryan. Oh, he took that in one-handed. What a grab. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that'll bring up a third and one. The Redskins on third down. They've converted 4 times out of 6. Not bad. They need just a yard here. It's third and one. Here's Ryan to throw. Jordan Reed has it. A pickup of 5 that time and a first down. And a 2-score game, obviously. Every play, every third down, like we saw there, magnified. Big pickup.
It was a huge pickup. What they really want, though, is to not even get to third down. They've got to maximize time and conserve as much as possible.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. From the shotgun, Ryan. And he finds the tight end, Reed. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. Second and 3. Now a quick throw as that's complete on the hitch route. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. Now, correct me if I'm wrong. Yeah, you're down 2 scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to full 2-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call 2 plays in a huddle each time you snap the ball.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. Those passes out that far wide always make you hold your breath a little bit. Felt like it was in the air for a while.
And what it does is allows a defender to gain some ground, come from a long distance, and have a chance to affect the pass.
This is Geis. And he's eaten up at the line of scrimmage. Might have gotten a yard down to the 16. The Redskins on third down. They've been very good, 5 for 7 thus far. This is 3rd and 9. From the gun, it's Ryan. He's got his man. This is Jackson. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to 4th down.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. They'll try and throw for it with Ryan. And this is caught in the end zone. It's Dotson for the Redskins' touchdown. Josh Doxson, his first touchdown on the year, as his guys are back within a single score.
Okay, I know it's an old line, but it still applies here. The fat lady has not sung yet. She may be warming up, but she hasn't sung yet. There's still an opportunity.
Lambeau on for the extra point. And this is back to a five-point game. So that one, a long 11-play drive. And the result, a touchdown for Washington. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So here are the Falcons to take over on offense. They're working on a four-game winning streak, and they lead this one as well right now as they start first and 10.
Hey, Charlie!
They'll start with Hunt on the ground. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4.
All right, that's a decent game there, but it hasn't been his best game overall. So I wonder what the mindset is of his team. Do they want him to handle the football and try and close this game out? Or are they going to make an alternative plan and maybe go in a different direction?
I think they need him, and this is his time to shine. Off play action. Pace. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Haynes. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. A big play on the catch and run, covering 34 yards.
It's not a surprise when you read scouting reports and watch tape because you know he's a heck of a player. But he is so difficult to get down in the open field. They just want to get him the ball and let him do his thing.
Here's a throw over the middle. It's taken in by his tight end. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. Fourth quarter. Down to the final 2 minutes. And we've got a one-score game.
Watch the run. Watch the run.
So it's Falcon football as we welcome you back. They've got a second down now as they search for a way to get this one to the finish line. Here's Hunt. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. So fresh out of the 2 minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. Now this is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop him here. Operating from the gun, Pace. Open man is Taylor, he's got it. Oh, no, he lost the football, and the Redskins scoop it. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Out there ready for this next drive, the Redskins offense. And things are starting to move in the right direction. They get the touchdown last drive, then their defense gets them the football back.
Yeah, now they have a chance to get the lead if they can put something together here. And I'm eager to see how they decide to do it. They want to be methodical, or do they want to take the big strike and go after it right now?
He's back to throw.
Partner, they're clearly saving those timeouts, but they still have to work with some urgency to put themselves in the right position.
They come up now, third and 5, following the incomplete pass.
Hey, alert 3, alert 3, get up!
Back to throw. He's got his target, it's Cobb! And he's able to get the first here as he's taken down at the 25. Now Ryan inside of him, and oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted, picked off at the 45, and they'll start out with great field position at the 47-yard line in enemy territory.
And that one, oh, it's going to hurt big time. You're in the two-minute drill trying to get your guys down the field, and it's looking like they're going to go just short. As this is definitely not his best throw, and it'll wind up being intercepted.
Now Washington going to use the second of their three timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in the fourth. So they come up on second down, and they can get another run like we just saw. Would likely put an end to this thing.
I just intercepted it.
And he gets
this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. The Redskins going to go ahead and use their final timeout as he'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the game.
Let's get off the field, D. Let's get off the field, D.
Kill, 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 kill. Hey, turn it up, turn it up.
On first down, Hunt. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. Didn't get to the sticks, but that's an ideal carry there on first down, isn't it?
I mean, now you're second and one. Although, you know, in the NFL, even if you picked up the first down, I don't think it's a big difference because the clock doesn't stop.
Yeah, not like college.
Right. If it's college football, you want to make second and one is probably better than picking up the first down because in college football, the clock stops with every first down and actually aids the defense in that situation.
They'll try to run for the first down with Hunt. And he's going to be taken down here, still a couple yards short of the first. And with inside of 10 seconds, 8 to be precise, we get whistles and a timeout on the field. And here's a big one now. Try to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. They'll try and run for it. And he's across touchdown. For the late touchdown. And in the final seconds, that one should just about put a capper on this game. So a little icing on the cake there before the clock hits all zero.
What a way to finish things off. Exactly what you want. Not much time and a touchdown to put things away.
Extra point splits the uprights.
I had
it. Gives his guys a 12-point advantage. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This is taken at his 4.
Here we go, here we go, here we go.
So time runs out. It's a victory for the Atlanta Falcons, and they were buoyed, Charles, by a big second half that put this one on ice.
So you get the sense that whatever was said at halftime obviously hit home. I think it's a little bit more than that, though. Obviously, there are words that are said, and, hey, come on, guys, we have to play better. But sometimes it's just sharpening your execution, sharpening your focus, and maybe doing the things you practiced all week without major adjustments, just doing them better. And that got it done in this one.
So for the Falcons, they improved to 5-0 now on the young season. And they will hit the road next week for a date with the San Francisco 49ers. Meanwhile, for the Redskins, it's loss number 3 for them on the year. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, we thank our entire crew. I'm Brandon Gauden. This is the NFL on EA Sports.